These parcels could make all the difference for families who are desperate for help while in lockdown. Kids Can, who are now able to help through lockdown, have changed their service to reach out to families who are struggling nationwide.
We have worked with our schools and they have given us a list and details of families that are most vulnerable, most in need. We know that there will be a high percentage of Māori and Pasifika families that are receiving these parcels.
3,000 of these parcels filled with things like rice, pasta and canned foods are being shipped to households all over the country. A large number of them are Pasifika. Almost 30% of Pacific kids in New Zealand are living in material hardship, meaning they go without things like shoes or fresh fruit and vegetables. Before the lockdown, schools like Rosebank Early Childhood Centre were dealing with students who were always hungry, often becoming sick or not showing up to class at all.
They hardly come to school because they don't know what to bring to school. And I say to their parents, why your child is not coming to school? And so they're waiting for the welfare money coming from the government. Once they get there, then they will bring their children in. When I look at their lunch boxes too, that makes me sad. Only chips, $2 chips, you know, the packet, $2. That's all they have. They can't even afford to buy a bread, a jam or whatever. It's very heartbreaking. When I saw that, and I said to myself, we need to do something to these children, you know.
And so the teachers signed the school up for the Kids Can Food for Schools program that supplies food as well as free shoes and raincoats, a relief especially for the parents.
I love that they change so much from eating unhealthy food to like eating healthy food. And I don't have to visit the doctors like almost every week, once a week, like which is so good, like save my life.
They love to bring their kids to school because it's stressless, nothing to worry about. We provide healthy food here. We provide everything for their children. Their children are healthy. They hardly go to the doctors.
And while kids are receiving help through their schools, Pacific families are dealing with more complex issues at home.
Our community is largely made up of such hard-working people who do so much with very little. So a lot of our community are the working poor, and then we also have a lot of Pasifika who are disconnected from families for different reasons, who need to rely on our welfare system as a safety net, and it's not catching.
Advocates like Child Poverty Action Group acknowledge government's actions to reduce child poverty, but are pushing for more systematic changes.
It's just the beginning of a wider conversation around increasing those core benefits, around the living wage, around housing and health and access to that.
We believe ele mafai ona nofole poto ele mafau faul tamaititi be a molele manawa. The wisdom is not going to stay there if the child is hungry.